Are you taking the AP Computer Science Principles exam? Well, you might have done all your preparation, all the practice queries, and now you're just doing your final prep. Or maybe you're just trying to cram in whatever you can. Either way, this video will help. So we can look at example questions. They're not going to be the questions that are in the exam, but they can help us understand what type of questions are going to be in the exam. There are some questions that do seem to be repeated every year, such as like with lists. So if you know they start at 1, the index, then there will be a question perhaps selecting an item from a list using the index. And another one that's popular is swapping two items in a list using the temp variable in pseudocode. One exam tip that I found useful is to answer the easy questions first, leave the more difficult ones to later when you know you have more time. What type of questions are likely to be in the exam? Let's have a look. Well, you probably already know it's multiple choice, 70 questions over 2 hours. And we can read about what type of areas are likely to be in there. So what we're going to cover in this video, we're going to look at computing questions. We're going to look at network questions, then we can look at programming questions, data questions, and questions involving algorithms. One thing you notice here is this logic table. So if you get a question about Boolean logic, you might need to know about the AND and OR logic tables, meaning 2 truths make a true, 2 false make a false. But true and false and true, well, they're both false if you use an and they're both true if you use an or. So that's something that you would need to know if you get a question on that in the exam. So now let's have a look at each section, starting off with questions about computing. Okay, computing questions. So we start off with the simple questions about how computers work. So this involves things like bits and binary and encoding. So examples. Which of the following can be stored in a bit? Now this question has 2 answers. There are multi-answered questions in the exam. What could be stored in a bit? Pretty much anything that has 2 values. So mod 2 either gives you 0 or 1. So that would be an answer. A Boolean variable, that would be the other answer. So the answer would be A and B. We have binary questions, so convert this number to decimal or a decimal number to binary. So that's just a simple convert question. The answer to that was 155. Then we have questions about errors. So if it's a large number, it's going to be an integer answer. So we've got here an integer overflow error. And the other error would be the rounding error. Encoding questions, compression, lossless and lossy. Hex numbers might not be in the exam, but if they are, it's just a question of multiplying the last number by 1 and the second last number by 16. So second last number here is F, which stands for 15. Has the value 15 in hexadecimal. 15 times 16 would be 240 plus 1, so the answer would be 241. So in this question, it's only the number, the rest of the text, the answer is just, it doesn't matter. Again, another hex question. We've got general computing questions, things about like user interfaces, copyright, simulation. Again, another simulation question. Citizens, scientists, innovations. So if you've looked through your course notes, you'll probably find that you understand these areas and can answer these questions. Remember, most are simple multiple choice, but there are questions with 2 answers. Network questions. Perhaps the first thing to say about network questions is a lot of it's on protocols and packets. And protocols mainly based on TCP and IP because they're used for the internet. So we can think of the different layers when we talk about networks. And IP is the layer that sends all the packets around. TCP is the layer that kind of makes sure that they get there and deals with problems if there's any problems with lost packets, for example. So TCP and IP are generally used in questions. We have questions about what are protocols, what do packets do and how do they get to their destination. So many questions about how packets are reassembled, bandwidth, the maximum bit rate, transmitted, domain, the domain name, again TCP IP. Architecture, we're looking at the terms that we used in the course. So we're looking at words like redundancy and fault tolerant. So a network, you don't want a system to crash when there's one problem. So you don't want one point of failure. You want the network to be able to carry on. Other questions include like attacks, like hacking or malware, viruses. So this one, a phishing scam is by email. So the answer would be A in this question. And causing a website to slow down and crash would be a distributed denial of service attack, for example. Okay, let's move on to programming questions. So with programming, we've got general programming questions. We've got coding questions using pseudocode. We've got the kind of like a board with a robot that can move. So you just need to look at the direction and move left, forward or right. And we've got some logic questions. So Boolean expression, Boolean logic. So let's have a look at examples. How do you make your code more readable? Boolean expression, so true or false. In this case, it says which is not. So the last one just gives x a value of x plus 42. So that's not a Boolean expression. Again, more Boolean logic. With this one, because it's slightly more complicated, you need to understand the and or, because you've got true or not false, true and false, true or false, with a false or solution to that. So it's a bit more involved, but if you can understand or remember the and or part, then you can work out the answer. So in this example, we've worked out that 1 and 3 are false. So Boolean gates, again, more logic. And then we look at the concepts in programming. So this is an if-else. There aren't really many trick questions in the exam, but you may find some of the code is a little bit wrong. So therefore, that might be a trick question. Or even you look at the code and it says, what's the output? But there's no display. And if there's no display in the code, there won't be any output. So they're normally the only type of trick questions. So you get questions asking what the code does. Might have nested if statement questions. So asking maybe what the output is. Loops, how many times will it go around? Lists, mentioned before about the index, or in this example, which of the code is correct. In this example, I think neither are correct. And procedures, loops, lists, test data, all of these type of questions. Again, procedure, what's the output? So these are different types of programming questions. Also in the exam, you may see many tables and you'll have questions about the data in those tables. So as long as you understand the table and the data inside, should be quite straightforward. So here, for example, we have some data in a table. Question, what can't be decided? So it says, if days where the temperature was 80 degrees Fahrenheit were also raining, you can see in the table it says rain day before a game. So that would be the answer. So straightforward, just have to read the question correctly and understand the table. Big data, how's it useful? Data mining, why would you use it? How would you use it? Cloud storage. Metadata, so data about data. So here we've got an example where we've got data about the exercise, the research. So they're recording about sea turtles. So we can see information about that in A, B, and C. Whereas D is talking about the metadata, the data about the data. Data analysis, how we can use it. And this is a little bit more complicated. In this example, you could probably just look at the table and get an idea quickly, and then at the end, when you have more time, work it out correctly. But you can see, if we look 220, 200, the next number is going to be 2000. 1, 2, 300, next is going to be 400, 250, 300, 350, 400. So the last one we've got 0.1, then 1, then 100. So the next number is going to be 10,000. So in this question where we're looking at what's going to happen in the next column, we've got a good idea of what the answer is without really checking the answer. And then once we do the math, we can see that we were correct, that D was the correct answer. So maybe get an idea of what the answer is, but if it looks like it's going to take a little bit of time, then maybe do that, the whole calculations at the end of the exam, when you'll have plenty of time at the end. Now let's finally move on to the algorithm questions. There shouldn't be too many algorithm questions in the exam, but what questions will there be? Well, we can look at areas such as the design, we have iteration, and we have selection and sequential. Types of algorithms like binary search and heuristics, and also we might see some algorithms in the coding. If you want to look at these questions in more detail, please visit our website where we have all of these questions and answers and other information and tips. Downloads, we can see you want the exam reference sheet with the pseudocoding and the vocabulary to practice. We have details, courses to help you with more questions. These are the articles that we've covered today. We have videos on YouTube with the 30-day challenge. We have questions every day in April. And if you want to see what mark you might get, you can use this score calculator table. We've covered what questions might be in the exam. If you have any other questions, there's an article here that previous students have written about what they feel about the exam and the course. So don't forget, if you do take the exam, let us know how you got on. Let us know about the questions. What questions were in the exam and which ones weren't? If you're taking the exam, we wish you so much good luck. I'm sure you'll smash it. Talking of smashing, why not smash that like and subscribe if you're new to the channel. Good luck.